You deserve my worship. You deserve my praise. Thank you, Jesus. Adoration and glory, it belongs to you always. Oh, you deserve my worship. Yes, you do, Lord. You deserve my praise. Adoration and glory belongs to you. Goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out hallelujah. I just want to thank him for saving me. Oh,
you deserve my worship.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. Make a joyful shout to the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. And into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And goodness to all generations. Oh, let us worship the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise God, praise God. Yes, Lord, I just want to worship. Just want to praise you forever and ever. Let's lift our voices.
I just want to praise you.
Forever, come on.
Forever.
deserves the praise. He deserves the glory and the honor. Yes. Our word for this week, and we're just going to give just an opening. We usually give the definition on Tuesday, but we're going to share with you just a few moments. Our word for this week is discernment. Discernment is a noun, the ability to judge well, and judgment, taste, discrimination. Those are some things you can look that up in the Webster Dictionary. We're going to be talking about that, and then we're going to be pulling out in the Bible discernment. And discernment is one of the gifts of the Spirit. We're going to be searching that. If you have a commentary, the Knaves commentary is a good one. There are several commentaries. If you have a topical Bible, you can go in your concordance and look up the word, and it'll give you scriptures. So we're not doing a detailed depth study. So we're just giving you some something to ponder over, something to make you go, that will cause you to want to search it out and find out more about it. In the Christian context, it's the perception in the absence of judgment. That means in the absence of judging someone else. When you perceive a thing, you don't judge that individual. You look beyond that flesh and see what is spiritually going on with a view of attaining spiritual guidance and understanding. Without providing for a time of healing, this is in discernment, there will be no hope of living through this present moment without a shattering of our common life. And as we are in this COVID-19, this shift in our new normal, without the sense of discernment, without knowing that God is working on our behalf and being able to see past what's right now, and know that it's going to work out for your good, then we would be most hopeless and most miserable, as Paul stated once before. I'm going to do some research. The Wikipedia is a free set of encyclopedias. Of course, you can go and get that. And so I don't reinvent the wheel. Okay, I gather information and look at resources. And so I'm not impressed with myself, but I come that you may be inspired, that you may be able to be inspired to look within yourself and see what God is saying to you, that your perception, your eyes, your spiritual eyes, your spiritual perception will be enlightened, and know that this is a virtue, that you add to your faith certain things that you may be able to grow thereby. Okay, when we come into salvation, salvation is not just to save you from going to hell, but salvation is to prepare you that you may be able to do the good works that God has assigned for your life, that you may be a representative in the earth for the Father of all. Because we know that we operate in multiple positions and multiple gifts, and so we may be able to understand that, yes, we are a child of God, and heaven is guaranteed us, but while we are in the earth, we are like Jesus Christ. We are representing the kingdom from which we come, and we're representing the King, who is the King of all kings, King of kings and Lord of lords. And we need the discernment, and the Holy Spirit helps us to spiritually make discernments or perceptions, or come to a wisdom and knowledge of understanding. So discernment is the ability to obtain sharp perceptions, or to judge well, or the activity of so doing. Considered as a virtue, a discerning person is considered to possess wisdom, okay, and be of good judgment, especially so with regard to subject matters often overlooked by others, okay, because sometimes we just see what's there, we don't really see, okay. In Christianity, the word may have several meanings. Discernment can describe the process of determining God's desire in a situation or for one's life, or identifying the true nature of a thing, such as discerning whether a thing is good, evil, or may even descend the limiting notion of duality. Okay, because sometimes we look at a thing and we might perceive it as one thing, and God is using it for another thing. In large, it describes the internal search for an answer to the question of one's vocation, namely determine whether or not God is calling one to the married life, single life, consecrated life, ordained ministry, or any other calling. Okay, and so just know that God has given us discernment, and all of us have a level of discernment, and then there are some that are endowed with the gift of discernment, and we'll talk a little bit about that as the week progress. So be blessed, my brothers and my sisters, and remember, get in the know today and you can change your every tomorrow. Yes, you are empowered to change your life. If you have a gift down inside of you, a treasure in an earthen vessel, that the excellency may be of God. And so we thank you for your attentiveness to yourself and becoming the best you that you can be. Pull your gift out, share it with the world, exercise your spirit of discernment, and also make sure that you are fruited with the Spirit of God, that you, the fruit of the Spirit, so you will not be reckless with your gifts. He has fruited us and gifted us that we may be a blessing to the body of Christ. Yes, we are the body of Christ. Many members, one body. Jesus Christ is the head of the church. He's the head of the body. We are the living, walking organism, which is organized by the Spirit of God, that we are his representative in the earth. I am Ambassador L.F. Craig. Thank you. Have a blessed day. And know that God is on our side.
Some days are weary. Some days you're weary. And you can't see your way.
And you can't see your way.
Some nights are lonely.
Some nights are lonely.
With no one to say.
With no one to say.
You can make it.
You can make it.
It's only a test.
It's only a test.
You can take it.
You can take it.
And don't you think.
And don't you think.
So wipe the tears from your eyes.
Here's
the reason why. Come on.
God's on your side.
He can handle it. God's on your side. Hold on. God's on your side.
Can
handle it. God's on your side. Miss LeAndrea Johnson.
Yeah.
Somebody else, have a blessed day.
Because when we use our lives to bless others, it makes the world a better place. So I reached out to some of my friends that I know have blessed the world to encourage you to find a way
to bless somebody else.
Bless somebody else.
I know. Been faithful every day.
Yes.
And I believe God's hand is on my life. His hand is on my life. God has proven that He's faithful.
God has proven that He's faithful.
For eternity I will be grateful.
Sing it for me, Wes.
Blessed with so much.
So much.
How can I keep it,
how can I keep
to
it to myself?
Wes Moore.
Lord, I promise.
Every time you bless,
I'm gonna bless somebody else.
Bless me.
Help me to bless somebody else.
Thank you for your music, Fred. You have blessed us all.
Because I'm blessed. Because I'm blessed.
The one and only
else.
Faith Evans.
Who seen the harvest?
Every time you bless,
every time you bless,
you can trust
you
me.
You can trust
to
me.
Bless somebody else.
Trust me to bless somebody.
Pass the smoking off of my man.
Hearts in the harvest.
Your harvest.